Hello, parents. My name is Amy Gale. I'm going to be your child's photography teacher this trimester. And I hope to make it as fun and enjoyable and engaging as possible. So I'm just going to run through a couple key things that you should know. And if you have any questions or concerns, please always feel free to contact me. I have some information about myself. I've been at PC since 2016, so I came in with the ninth graders. So I love it. Here's my contact information if you need to email me. I try to be really good at answering you as fast as I can. Here's a link to my Schoology page with all the information for our students. And here are my office hours on Fridays. I did take a picture of the classroom. I took everything out that I could that wasn't essential. So there's 15 students in a class. There should be 15 computers. They're all 6 feet apart. I did put in arrows so all the students will come in one way and file in and sit down and we'll do our work. We'll try to get them up and moving. We have a door on the back of our classroom, so we'll be going outside a lot to try and take pictures and to do interactive things outside to give everybody some movement and fresh air. And then once the class is over, I do have to wipe down all the surfaces, and I will do my best to do that quickly and efficiently so that students aren't standing around wasting time, but we're all kept safe. What to expect when students are in class? We're going to do a lot of work on Adobe Photoshop, editing photos that they've taken outside of class. They'll learn different software using what we call a bridge program. We will go outside taking photo shoots, and I do plan to let them use the big backdrops and lights and studio equipment that we have. We do have large DSL cameras that we have used in the past. However, we do not have enough for everybody to have their own. And wiping down those with a sanitary solution, I don't think is going to be very safe for the cameras. It could damage them. So you can see what to expect outside of class. We do ask that your students take pictures with a phone or a camera that you have outside of class. And then we're going to be using the Google Drive to transfer those. So when they're at home, they'll be doing online work, same work that we would do in class, but it will be online and it will be digital, learning what makes a good photograph. And then they are to take pictures at home to apply this. And I'm actually really excited because I get to see more pictures that they take at home versus sending them out in the school. I kind of see the same things sometimes. So it'll be really good, I think. And I think your students, I hope, will enjoy it and be moving and active. A couple things that are different with my grading. The assignments in the Schoology page will open at 12 a.m. on Monday morning, and then they will close the following Sunday at midnight. So your students have 7 days that they can complete the work. Most of the time, it's maybe two, it's probably three, I think, three activities, and then some taking pictures. So two to three online activities, worksheet, video, brainstorming, researching, and then taking some photographs. And so please notice that once the folder closes, I ask that students get their work done during that time so I can keep the gradebook updated. They don't get piled up with work. It worked pretty well in the spring, and then about mid-trimester, I opened everything up for like 2 weeks. And if you didn't get your work done, you got 2 weeks to catch up on anything, and then it closes again. And so it gives them a second chance, but it also keeps them kind of motivated to kind of get the work done and move on, especially since we use that information that they're to be learning in all the time. So it's really important that they do their work when it's assigned. The other thing that's different, everything is formative. So you can kind of see on the slide, if we have five or six different assignments for a unit, everything from worksheet to research online to their photographs that they take to their final edited photographs and the reflection. Everything is weighted the same. And then what I do is I add up all their formative work and I give them a summative grade. So they're in charge the whole unit, what kind of summative grade they get. They can't not do any of the formative work and take a test and get an A. If they don't do the formative work, they're giving themselves a low summative grade. It's worked out well in the past, and most students that kind of figure out, they're like, oh, well, that makes sense because as long as I keep doing my work, I'm giving myself a good grade. And if I don't do my work, it kind of comes back. And so it motivates them too. So it seems to be very fair. And it puts all of the power in their hands. It's not me giving them a final project or test and saying, oh, you went from a D to an A. Nope, they're in charge the whole time. So if you have questions, let me know. Number scales, grade 4, 3, 2, 1. I do 3.5s, but nothing fancier. And then when they are in class, they will be giving what we call Criterion C grades, and those are kind of their work ethic. You know, are they coming in on time, prepared to work? Do they have a positive attitude? Are they using their time in class wisely? Are they using the materials wisely? A big part of working in a studio and collaborating with other students is being responsible for using the space and using the equipment. So that's a big part of their grade. And again, it's all up to them on how they want to control their behavior and come in and do what they're asked to do, and they give themselves a good score and a high grade. So Criterion Cs are also formatives. I mentioned this a little bit, the window, those 7 days a week that they can do their work. If it works better for students to work at night, that's fine. If it works better for them to get it away done right away, that's fine. But they do need to get that work in by midnight on that following Sunday. And then it keeps everybody a little bit more clear. And then when they come into the classroom, they have their photographs, so then we can edit them and do things with them. If they don't have their photographs, it's not much fun to edit. That is all I have. If you have any questions, feel free to contact me. I hope it's going to be a good trimester. Most students tend to really enjoy the class, so I'm lucky. I get to teach something kind of fun. Thank you.